Lightstream. The world of reflected light. We've gone very deeply into it. And Lightstream can be used for drama productions, major productions. And although the biggest light that we use there is a 1200 watt light, it still has serious output, more than a 9K array and spot. And we go into reflectors, and from those we go into more reflectors, and we have different reflector surfaces. Okay, now we've complemented that with a completely separate range of what we call Lightstream light. Those are complete sets that work with ridiculously light reflectors that weigh something like paper. And they have the same functions. They can be used in many different ways, and they exist with all the different surfaces. That can be used for interviews, that can be used for home streaming, video, Zoom, Teams communication, or it can integrate upstage into regular Lightstream. And now comes the third one that we want to talk about today. That's Lightstream tabletop. That's for the small sets, but again, it can also play in the other leagues, Lightstream light and regular Lightstream. And we can mix and match all the time. So today we want to introduce a little bit some of the tools and toys that we employ for Lightstream tabletop. And those are sets that you start with 15 of tiny reflectors, this size, again, all the different surfaces. Or even there we have structured reflectors with some kind of hammered surfaces, or even eflect in the small size. The multi-mirror bendable little effect, reflect thingadings that can create crazy patterns, dappled spots and so on. And to attach all these, we have a whole array of little gadgets and arms. What we've done here is one of the possibilities. We take the rails, exactly the same rails that we have on the backside of the Lightstream reflectors. That's what I designed. And into the rails, we can slip a holding device called the Lightstream reflector lock. And that can take arms in two directions. The big, heavy duty arms that we can introduce sideways or implement like this, and then they can hold any kind of weight. They're really wonderful. You really have to have some force to bend them, and they will not run away and float away. But there's an entire multitude of choices how you can then go on and continue. There are little adapter pieces that you can stick in here, and those again can mount onto quarter inch arms, and they can be locked, and they are very light and easy, and they can bend in any kind of ways. That's the same ones we use on some of the Lightstream light. Yeah, so that's another version. Or we have also plastic arms with many segments that can be moved in many different ways, and they can be extended, several of them in a row. And then we have longer gooseneck arms that are known for microphones and other applications, but they can also work here and form another tool or Then we have also long arms like this that can reach further away and be bent and shaped and hold reflectors. And then we have devices with which we can apply 4 or 5 such arms on one holder to have reflectors going like a strange animal all over the place to form a multitude of effects. And we can add also attachments with little clamps. Actually, there are 6 different sizes of such clamps that we can apply. And if we want to mount a light to the rail and move it further away, we can also use some marvelous device. It's this one here. You can carry it around in a little bag, and then you can extend it and extend it and extend it to really sizable length and lock it. And it looks very strong because of this construction. So it's a very strange version of a magic arm that can also be very useful. But you can have the same also in tiny versions. Yeah, and they really hold like crazy because they have little ratchets. Yeah, when you move them here, you can hear the ratchet, and that locks it super tight. And you have many different applications with a shoe mount, a 1/4-inch mount, all kinds of different toys to play with. So this is only an introduction to some of the tools and toys. Here is something that locks and has 2 arms. Yeah. And as you can imagine, on top of this, we can put another and another and another and have 2, 4, 6, 8 arms. And we can make long arms, short arms, because we can slide this through here and have 1 arm short and 1 arm long. And this allows us to put the reflectors any which way we dream of. So that's one thing. What we have done here is just an introduction of the tools and toys. This can be done much better and much more intricate. What we're trying to do here, for example, is to take a 90-watt LED light, high power, one of our best sellers, and that's our main light here. And it goes onto a hard reflector, slightly larger, and that is our simulation of the sun. Yeah, and that's something miracle about Lightstream and all the different categories. We can create the illusion of light from infinity. So for this little dollhouse, this is our sun, and it shines all the way through the dollhouse and even exits on the other side. And later on we'll put a little smoke and you can see the rays from this wonderful Lightstream sun. And then we have little lights like a bicolor 40-watt LED light with the magic parallel beam intensifier in front, and even the smallest one, ridiculous, an 8-watt light called the Ledzilla. And when you put the nose on it, the parallel beam intensifier, even that tiny little light starts putting fire into 1 reflector, 2 reflectors. It can light up 5 reflectors in a row that all share the same beam, and endless possibilities, endless ways to play and implicate and form and shape and explore, that we're only showing here as a symbol. And it's up to you to take your time to fulfill your dreams in the tiny world, or in the bigger one, or bigger, or in the mega world, or even like in the James Gray film, where they're in space, outer space, and they were looking for the light from infinity, from far and far away. And they played with all different kinds of lights, everything that's on the market. little Arri 18K, bounce into mirrors, and we have an interview from the gaffer who made all these experiments and played with it, and to find a light that symbolizes sunlight or light from infinity. There was only one that was our big light stream parallel beam light. So on a different scale, we have that for top superpower. We have it for light stream light, where in a lady's handbag, you can travel around the world and light an entire scene with one light. Believe it? With one light, lighting seven reflectors. He lit the entire scene with one light. How about that? It is not very impressive for the professionals because they love to boast with wattage and diesel generators and more power. And my friend David Pringle, he even builds a 200,000 watt light. Some people need that. But often these days, you can go very low power, where one little 8-watt light or a 40-watt light can create the lighting for an entire set with your key light, fill light, backlight, background light, and effects in the background, and another light on your product, or one light, many reflectors, the miracles, the playground. And this doesn't take away anything. Yeah, don't think that if I go down to 8-watt lights, I'm limiting myself. You're expanding the world of creative potential endlessly. And that's what we do. And this is just looking around at a little bit of the setup here to show you some of the toys. The lighting is not the way I would do it if I'd have another day time. And if Dwight Campbell would do this, he would make miracles from it and he would be led into a dream world. And the same is what Francois would do and others would do and you can do. Just take a little time and find out what miracles you can create. So here we are introducing Lightstream Tabletop, the little one. Thank you. I'm Dedo.